You could define anger as frustrated expectation. You want something really badly. You think of it as fundamental, it's obvious, it should be like this. And you don't get it. And that's where anger comes from. You're holding on very tightly. You think that your way is the best way. And everybody else should believe in your way and follow your way. In fact, you think you're smarter than God. So in anger, we are very attached to our way of doing things. Another word for anger is self-righteous. I'm right, everybody else is wrong. So the healing of this is to realize that you're not the only one who sees things. We all see things from different perspectives. And there's more to the story than you realize. There's more going on to it than what you realize. One thing about anger is, check, when you get angry, the first one who hurts is you. You may not even have said anything yet. You're burning already from the inside. Hey, listen, if you're the right person, you're doing everything right, it's not your fault, why should you be burning? Other people should be burning, right? But you're the one who's burning. Why? Because anger makes everyone burn. Doesn't matter who it is, rich or poor, educated or not, believing in this or that, doesn't matter. If you get angry in that moment, you burn. That's the law of nature. It's like picking up something really hot to throw at somebody else. You've already burned yourself. Now, it may not even hit the other person, you may miss the other person. So when we have perceptions like this, that anger first of all hurts me, anger is self-righteousness, I think I'm the only one who's right, there's no other way. The main point is take a moment to cool down. In that moment, when you speak and do something from a state of anger, you're going to damage that relationship. So like this, when you start realizing that peace of mind is more important than being right, ask yourself, do I want to be happy? Or do I want to be right? If you want to be right, you will always fight. If you want to be happy, then you learn to let go. You don't have to win every argument. Not every time you have to be the only one who's right. Like this, you have a much more peaceful existence. And yes, anger comes once in a while. You look back and check, what am I believing? What am I holding so tightly? Could I let it go? Would I let it go? When? And like this, you start coming out of it.